All right, it's time for me to show you again another old arcade game. This one is Gyruss or Gyruss. I've heard it pronounced both ways, and I've never really been 100% sure how to say it. Anyways, this is by Konami 1983. It's a very, very good game. Just get it out of the way right now. I highly recommend it, so I don't have to keep saying it, although I probably will by accident. And as you can see there, even though the AI failed to demonstrate that, it's a lot like Tempest, which is the reason I like it, because I really like Tempest. And it's also got a little bit of Galaga in there for good mix, so there you go. And, yeah, it's got some interesting things about it, but I'll get into it and explain to you. However, even though I'm kind of tired of saying this, which I probably don't have to at this point, but I will anyway, just because it's an arcade game, so it's hard intentionally. It's meant to eat your coins and tokens, so that's all there is to it. I'm actually fairly decent at this game, but I've never actually been able to beat it yet. I've gotten so close to the end, but I just am not that good at it to do that all the way through. Anyway, as you can see here, it'll be on the game info anyway, of course, but you can play two-player and the thing right below it. First bonus, 30,000 points, and then after that, it's every 60. That's when you get a life. You start out with 4, which is something I want to explain right now. You die in one hit, no matter what happens. You can die from being shot at, like you run into one of their shots, you know, they shoot at you, or you crash into something, or they crash into you. So that's how you die. You can also get this upgrade where you get dual shot, which is very useful, obviously, but you lose that. You know, you get hit once, you die, whatever, you just lose it. Also, say for example, when you first start, you have 4 lives, you never make it to the point where you can get another life with the 30,000 points there. If you lose all 4 of those, that's it. It's complete game over. You go to the high score screen, maybe you made it, most likely you didn't. Definitely not number 1 anyway. And you have to start the entire game over. Unlike some other arcade games, this isn't one where you have like continues, you can continue right from where you were. And it doesn't matter how many credits you have, so there's that too. Now, is this better than Tempest? That's hard to say. I think slightly this might be harder, and at the same time it could say Tempest is slightly harder, and it goes back and forth, but whatever. I like them both. As I said, I highly recommend this. It's worth playing. Just, that's all there is to it. This is also one of those few arcade games I wouldn't mind having the individual cabinet just for this game. This is one, by the way, when I first came across it, I didn't know much about it. I know about Konami, of course, which, you know, they made some really good stuff in the arcade. Like, probably the best example is Gradius. That did very well, especially in home systems, but anyway. I just took a chance on this, and I'm glad I did. It's really good. That's all there is to say. Very good game. Highly recommend it. Go play it on MAME or whatever else. This is also one of those arcade games that had a really weird-looking kind of aspect ratio to it. It had like a 90-degree turn to it. There's also like a, or you might know as a cocktail table design, but I called it just a table design. But anyway, yeah. So it had that going for it, too. Most of the time when I die in this, I'm actually crashed into or I crash into something. Every now and then, I run into one of their shots, but it's not as common. Let's put it that way. Another thing I find is you don't actually have to spin around all the time. Most of the time, I just stay at the bottom, and it keeps me alive long enough. Now, criticisms. I only really have 2, and they're minor, I admit. They're kind of pointless, you might say, but whatever. I figure I might as well tell you anyway, because that's what I'm doing here. Actually, I'll tell you right after this. Now, chance stage. This is the thing that's like Galaga. As you might know, in Galaga you get these bonus stages where you can't get hurt and can't get shot. Same here. You're completely safe. Just kill as many as you can to get as many points as you can. Get close to the amount of points to get another life, of course. It's all about points in these games. For many reasons. Just for score and lives. And, yeah, that's all you do here. For some reason they call it chance, but it's really just a bonus stage. Anyway, I don't know why they call it that. My criticisms. 1, I like the music in this. Don't get me wrong. I do. I just wish it was a little bit more interesting. I like Tempest music better. Just saying. Especially Tempest 2000. Seriously, I gotta plug this real quick. If you ever get a chance to play Tempest 2000 on the Atari Jaguar, do it, because it's an extremely good game and a very good version. Damn it, I can't believe I was that stupid. Oh well. Yeah, so that's all I have to say about that before I go talk about that forever. And, I can't. See, I'm kind of frazzled. Because I'm having to do this again, because I already recorded this, and I found the thing didn't record my damn voice. So I'm kind of annoyed by that. Anyway, so I'm having to do this again, which, hurrah. First time turned out so great, too. Oh well. What can I do? Doing this again. Anyway, one other thing I want to mention is sometimes when you have like 1 or 2 enemies left, I only notice with like 1, they'll sometimes just run away. They'll just leave. They'll go off to the side of the screen. My other criticism, because I kind of forgot about that and left off to something else, is that these blue asteroids here are a little too much in the very distance, like these blue enemies, so it kind of is a little confusing sometimes, but whatever, it's not that big of a deal. Like I said, my complaints with this are minor, and they really are. They're nothing that much of a pain in the ass. I thought I was going to get shot at right there. I thought I got hit. Oh, came close. Anyway. Actually, I'm doing fairly well, to be honest with you. Consider I'm talking. Usually I'd have one less life right now. Uranus, by the way. That's actually how you're supposed to pronounce that planet. Little general useless knowledge I know. I swear, sometimes when that happens, like right there, it looks like you're going to crash into him, but it doesn't sometimes. Oh well. This is going very good, though. As I mentioned, when I do these, and I lost my double shot again, I'm going to go through a second time, so maybe it'll go even better that time. Who knows? I think that's a good thing to do with these arcade games, just because. That brown ball that's in the middle of those things when they appear, that's the one that gives you the dual shot, by the way. So if you just want to focus on that one, go ahead, but I like to get them all if I can, just because. Shit! I went right into him. You saw that. Admit it. And there you go. Next one is Saturn, which is actually my favorite planet. And no, it's not the reason why I like the Sega Saturn, it's just the coincidence. Just, it is. Alright. It's more difficult when you only have one shot. Got him, I think. Yeah, it's not that easy when you only have one single shot, but get as many as you can. I'm not that far off from 60 points, really. Whatever, I'm talking at the same time while doing this. You know how it is. By now. Yeah. Oh. That was pretty good. It's going to get me close. Kind of. I'm not that far away, to be honest. I should be able to get 60. Let's see how it works. I didn't explain this yet, I don't think, but the free warps thing, whatever it's talking about for the planets, and damn, that sucks, is... I think I already have, but whatever. Just kill all the enemies you can. Don't crash into them. Don't get killed. That's all that means. It doesn't really mean much. It's not like you have to keep going a certain distance before you make it to the end and get to the next level. It's not what that's all about. Anyway. I'm waiting for the damn... There it is. That's how you know when the thing comes in where you can get your dual shot again. Always go for that, really. It's kind of... very integral, I'd say. I don't like playing without it. I went for that warp upside down. Genius! That's going pretty good. This game's actually got a fairly decent amount of levels to it, to be honest. Lasts a good while. I do much better when I'm not talking, of course. But, whatever. Plays really nice, though. Can't stress that enough. It's just a very, very, very nice game to play. Ooh, close. Cheeky, cheeky. I see what you're doing. Wow, I thought I actually did crash. I did crash. I crashed into the freaking asteroid, and a little bit before that, I got a life, apparently. But there you go. And first, I usually get that. I don't care what I put in for that. All right, so here we go. Second time through, and this time I'll be focused more. More than likely. And this will be it. So yeah, I really don't have anything else to explain with this. I do recommend this a lot. It's a very, very good game. Requires your concentration, of course, but, you know, whatever. If you like Tempest, go for this. That's all there is to it. If you want more of that. This, unlike Tempest, though, has got a little bit more, like, the sprite variety is nice, visually, you know. It's got a little bit more going on with that regard instead of just, like, geometric patterns and various colors like Tempest has. But whatever. If this game is better than Tempest, that's, I think, more of a personal thing. It's kind of subjective, really. Ahoo! Got him. If I can, I would like not to lose a life in any way. You can lose a life until, like, 4. Whether or not that... No. It's like my hand froze. It knows it wants to screw with me. Whatever. It's going good, though. Aha, got him. That's what I'm talking about. That's the kind of result I like. I got a feeling this guy's just gonna leave because I won't be able to get him. Oh, no, never mind. I don't like when they leave. I want to get them all. I can't help it. Alright, now let's see how good I can do in the chance stage. I don't care that they call it that. I call it bonus. Because it makes more sense. I guess the idea, maybe, is why they call it chance, is you're taking a chance to see how good you do at it. I don't know, that seems a little weird. Every other game I've ever played in my life, particularly arcade games like this, always called bonus. I guess maybe because they call bonus your lives, like on the main, before you start the game, maybe they don't want to call it the same thing twice. I have no idea. Alright, stage 4. 3 warps. Longer than what the last one was. I like how sometimes when the enemies come in, if you're good enough, you can mash the button fast enough, you can kind of take them all out in their little wave there. It doesn't always work, and you don't really want to linger right where they were. Oh, how did I live through that? I almost hit the asteroid, that was my fault, and I almost got shot. That worked out better than I could have ever imagined. I don't like those barrier enemies either. A lot of times I screw that up. Sometimes I think I got them both and then nope. Nasty surprise waiting for you. Kinda like that, that was my fault. Alright, come on, I can get him. I got this. There's only one button, by the way, you play with to shoot. That's what I'm mashing right now. You just rotate around. That all works good. Whoa! Get that barrier again. Ah, ha, ha. Oh! I was trying so much to get the dual shot, and I kinda, yeah, caused myself to, ruin it for myself. Essentially, that's what happened. I think this guy might leave, or can I get him? No, I can't get him. I can get one of the things that causes the barrier, but... Oh no, there he is. He's dead. Yeah, okay. I thought the bonus stage was coming up again, but no. It's not doing that. Oh. It's not the place I want to be. Alright, seriously, where's the thing at so I can get my dual shot again? I'm waiting for it to warp in. Took care of a lot of you guys. The other thing is, I just thought of something to mention, is many of you might know, Konami's pretty well known for doing this thing where they... Shit, not that. Is where they change, like, they use the same enemy over and over and they just palette swap them. That's going on a little bit in this, but not as bad as some games, like TMNT4 or something like that, you know. They don't just recycle the same damn enemy and change the color. They do that in this, just not as much as some other of their games. I don't know why I just mentioned that, it's just, I thought it maybe be worth mentioning, I guess, I don't know. So now I've made it to Uranus again. And now it's the bonus stage, which is what I've been looking forward to. See how many, if I can get close enough to 60, I might be able to prolong this a little bit more. Might be able to go a little bit further. Yeah, there you go. No rapid fire in this game. Yes. I think I only missed like... Oh wait, just stole this. Oh, I'm not gonna get them all. Oh, I missed like 4 of them. I think. Pretty sure there's like 40 in each one. Most of the time I can get like 39 of them. I always miss one for whatever reason. It's usually that last wave there. Why, I don't know. It's just, that's the one. Just the way it is. I tell you what though, even though I'm not really that big into the music in this, it is fast and frantic and it does keep the pace up, so it does match what's going on, you know. It does fit, at least. I just wish it was a little bit more interesting. It's a little kind of bland for me. Then again, of course, the solution is play your own music. My favorite planet, Saturn. I just noticed. Yet, space looks the same. Oh, gotta be careful. Don't want to get that close to him like that. It's bad. Just, that's the reason why it's bad. I'm so close to 60,000 points, that's not even funny. And I got it. But I didn't get a life. Weird. Is that just me, or did I find that weird myself? There you go, got my dual shot again. You know, here's something else I want to mention. It's not really pertains to this game specifically, but it can, because it's happened in this to me quite a few times. Sometimes in these kind of games, I don't even pay attention. I'm so focused on what I'm doing. I actually end up going pretty far when I have, like, literally one life left like I do right now. I am on my last life right now. Alright, seriously, let's buckle this down and get to Saturn. Let's get to my favorite planet. Not crash, not get shot down, not do anything stupid. I can do this. I really can. I just gotta really screw up. Oh well. what can I say? But you get a very good look at, I think, of Gyruss, whatever. Hey, I beat my other score. I don't know what I'm putting in. CC catch. Anyway, so that's Gyruss, whatever you want to call it, by Konami. Very good. Again, I recommend it highly. Give it a shot. And so that's it. Thanks for watching and listening, and I will see you next time.